It was not a fever dream. Sagwa the Chinese Siamese Cat from PBS Kids was created by Cine Group and Sesame Workshop and based on the book by Amy Tan, who's also the author of The Joy Luck Club and several other novels. The show features Sagwa, her siblings, friends, and parents, who are the official calligraphers for the magistrate in their province during the Qing Dynasty. And contrary to popular belief, Sagwa wasn't actually a Siamese cat. She was born with white hair, but obtained her markings after falling into an ink pot. The clever and sometimes bossy little cat, whose name means silly melon, would go on adventures with her brother, Donghua, whose name means winter melon, her sister, Shigua, whose name means watermelon, and her best friend, Fufu, whose name means lucky bat. Together, the friends would learn about family obligations and loyalty while playing games and hanging out in the palace's attic, or as they called it, the clubhouse. The show enjoyed a pretty decent fan base when it aired in 2001, and was quite unique at the time in the way it taught viewers about Chinese culture, legend, and language. Even the opening theme song was in both Chinese and English. But despite winning awards at both the Chicago International Film Festival, WorldFest Houston, and an Emmy, the show was canceled after only one season. However, reruns aired on some PBS networks all the way up until 2009, and could still be seen on some international channels throughout the world until 2019. To this day, Sagwa still does enjoy a cult following, in part due to a viral BuzzFeed post that featured the show's theme song, and there are also rumors that there may be a reboot in the works. Did you watch Sagwa the Chinese Siamese Cat? Has the theme song been stuck in your head for the past 20-some-odd years too? Let me know in the comments, and tell me what you want to hear about next. A big reason The Weekenders is one of the best animated shows ever made, besides the fact that Wayne Brady wrote and performed the theme song, is that the cast is iconic voice actor royalty. Tino was brought to life by Jason Marsden, who has been in a ton of projects, but is commonly recognized by fans as the voice behind characters such as Max Goof in A Goofy Movie, the cat form of Thackeray Binks in Hocus Pocus, and Haku in the Spirited Away English dub. Kath Soucie, who played Tish, has also been in just about everything ever made, but is especially beloved for her portrayal of Lil and Phil in The Rugrats, Lola Bunny in Space Jam, and Dexter's mom from Dexter's Laboratory. Gray Delisle, one of my personal favorite voice actors, played Lore, and also Azula from Avatar The Last Airbender, Daphne in Scooby-Doo Mystery Incorporated, Catwoman in Batman Arkham City, and has quite literally been a part of almost 700 other productions. Phil LaMarr played Carver, who we all know and love from Static Shock, Hermes Conrad from Futurama, Green Lantern John Stewart from Justice League, and over 500 other projects both on camera and behind the mic. Cree Summer, actual living legend who has brought her signature voice to hundreds of roles and is best known for Susie Carmichael in Rugrats, Kida from Atlantis, and Cleo from Clifford the Big Red Dog, played not only Carver's mom in the show, but also Penny and Todd. Jeff Bennett, who voiced Johnny Bravo, even played the pizza guy, and Carrie Kenny, who produced and co-starred in Reno 911, can be heard as Tish's mom. The show has always had a special little place in my heart because it was created by Doug Langdale while he was living in San Diego, which the fictional city in the series is based on. I also always really related to Tino because I was a goofy, neurotic kid myself. But I want to know who your favorite character was. Let me know in the comments if you longed for a constantly theme-changing pizza place in your own neighborhood, and what series you want to hear about next. Later days! One of the reasons Recess was such a great show is because whoever did the voice casting on this series was amazing at their job. Gretchen Grundler was brought to life by Ashley Johnson, who also played Ellie in The Last of Us, Tulip in Infinity Train, and Pike in The Legend of Vox Machina. Spinelli was portrayed by Pamela Adlin, who you might know as Bobby from King of the Hill, Vidya from the Tinkerbell series, Gunther from Adventure Time, Sonia from Big Mouth, and Tabby from The Loud House, just to name a few of the literally hundreds of projects she's been a part of. Gus Griswold was played by Cortland Mead, who was that super cute kid from the 90s The Little Rascals movie, Lloyd from Lloyd in Space, Flounder in the Little Mermaid Sega Genesis video game, and he was also in A Bug's Life. Vince LaSalle was voiced by Ricky Deshaun Collins, who also played Tucker Foley in Danny Phantom and provided additional voices in Happy Feet, Static Shock, and Once Upon a Forest, if you remember that deep cut. And of course, Andrew Lawrence played TJ, who we all know as the youngest Lawrence brother from Brotherly Love, if you're of a certain age. But what you may not know is he was also Nick Ramos in Dead Rising 3. The only actor out of the bunch who didn't do a ton of other voiceover work was Jason Davis, who tragically passed away in 2020. But he was also in Beverly Hills Ninja, Rush Hour, Roseanne, and current millennial throwback obsession. personally, my favorite was always Spinelli.
Scram, you little monkey booger!